Hey guys, and welcome back to the Exodus channel, your home for the best crypto videos. Hit those like and subscribe buttons and we will keep the videos coming. A common question for crypto newbies is why are there so many different types of Bitcoin? Scrolling down the crypto rankings will show you there's a host of assets that have BTC in their name, like RenBTC, Bitcoin BEP2, and Wrapped Bitcoin. All of these variations of Bitcoin can be quite confusing, but the explanation is quite simple. None of these tokens are the real Bitcoin, but they do have Bitcoin as an underlying asset. Bitcoin tokenization is a way to lock up or transfer the value of Bitcoin to other blockchains. The idea was first conceived by the Wrapped Tokens Project, which is a joint effort between Ren, Kyber Network, and the institutional asset custodian BitGo. The process of locking up the Bitcoin and turning it into an ERC-20 token is known as wrapping. Once the BTC is turned into an ERC-20 token, it can be used in Ethereum's rapidly expanding DeFi ecosystem. This means that instead of just buying Bitcoin and holding it, investors can now buy wBTC and use it to earn passive income in a number of ways. The wBTC holders can take out loans on decentralized lending platforms like MakerDAO or Aave and effectively borrow against the asset that they wish to hold, which can be very useful in a bull market. WBTC can also be used to provide liquidity on platforms like Uniswap, giving you a small percentage of the fees from the trades that happen in that specific pool. Similarly, it means that you can stake your Bitcoin on platforms like Compound, which pay you interest on your asset in order to actually facilitate lending. Using WBTC also opens Bitcoin traders to more trading pairs on decentralized Ethereum-based exchanges like Uniswap and KyberSwap. These use cases seem to be quite popular because as of today, over $8 billion worth of WBTC has been minted and sent into the Ethereum network. But before WBTC can be minted onto the Ethereum blockchain, every WBTC token has to be backed by exactly one Bitcoin. This guarantees the value of the asset, whereas the security of the WBTC is backed by Ethereum. But BTC is a much more secure asset than WBTC, and the increased utility is a trade-off for weakened security. Another trade-off when using WBTC is that BitGo, the entity which actually holds the WBTC and the keys needed to mint them, is a centralized company.
Backed by Goldman Sachs and other top investors, BitGo brings together the best of Wall Street and Silicon Valley to deliver institutional-grade security, compliance, and services.
Despite BitGo's positive security record up until now, they or any other third party that gains access to their accounts have the power to freeze operations, divert WBTC, or prevent people from redeeming their Bitcoin.
I got 242 Bitcoin in here.
Okay, Tom. All right. Here you are. You sign this. You get your money in 60 days.
60 days?
Well, that's what you agreed to when you bought your shares.
With the rising popularity of RenBTC and synthetic BTC, plus the emergence of Polkadot cross-chain DeFi, the Ethereum version of Wrapped Bitcoin could actually face some strong decentralized competition in the future. But for now, though, it is still commanding 72% of the tokenized Bitcoin market. And for the crypto space in general, any way to import Bitcoin's huge liquidity into the DeFi space could be a win-win for all involved. What are your Bitcoin price predictions for 2021? Let us know in the comments below. And if this video helped you understand what Wrapped Bitcoin is, then give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more crypto videos from Exodus.